That's why here today, you don't know what to celebrate. You don't know what to celebrate. Because God said you would fall so far away that you wouldn't know nothing but what your enemy taught you. You wouldn't know how to dress but behind your enemy told you.
Right.
You wouldn't know how to make money but behind your enemies told you.
Right.
God said that would happen. That's the black community right now. Come on.
And there ye shall be sold.
Ye shall be what?
Ye shall be sold unto your enemies.
When we get off the slave ships, was we sold to our friends? Was we sold to our friends? Who was we sold to? Who are they? What does God call them? Our enemies. That's who we were sold to. We were sold to our enemies. We are our own enemies, but you know who we learned that from? The white man.
Right.
Because we was all together in slavery. You understand? We came over here on the same damn slave ship.
Right.
We was late. We was the woman over here, the men right here, the babies right here. That's how we came over here. That's how we came over here. Yeah, we go each other. I'm going to read it again. Give me Proverbs chapter 3, verse 31. This is why we go against each other right here, because we learned it from the white man. That's what we learned it from. We learned it from him. Say it again. Right, but if you're trained for so long a certain way, it's going to be very hard for you to do something different. It's like hard to teach a new dog, an old dog, new tricks, right? It's hard. Why? Because that dog been living his life for so long one way. But if that dog was younger, it'd be a lot easier to train. That's how we are as a people. We've been here for 400 years keeping no commandments. We've been here for 400 years not keeping no commandments. My brother's still out here with no fringes on.
Right.
My sister's still out here in their underwear. You understand? 400 years later, we not a little dog no more. It's real hard to teach commandments to us today. Right? But God said he's called a remnant that shall repent. He's called a remnant that shall repent. Come on.
Proverbs chapter 3 and verse 31. Envy thou not thy oppressor.
God say, don't envy your oppressor. Come on.
And choose none of his ways.
Have we chosen the ways of the white man today? Have we chosen the ways? Who brings drugs into the community? Who brings drugs into the community? Who is it? My brother right here. Who brings drugs into the community? Who brings drugs into the community? Who? Who? The white man. Everybody, it's common knowledge. The white man brings drugs into the community. Right? Now, which one of you is copping from the white man? Who copping from the white man? Who? You copping from the white man? Who copping? Ain't nobody copping from the white man.
Right.
Because the white man is going to bring the drugs into the community for the Negroes to sell drugs to the Negroes.
Right.
That's what the white man's going to do. He's going to bring in a load of drugs, a load of guns, and say, y'all have at it. Y'all have it. Just make sure y'all kill each other. Keep that shit out of my neighborhood. Y'all do that shit in your neighborhood.
Jeez.
You understand? That's what the white man does. That's what the white man does. You understand? So he has become what to you? Your enemy. Because God said that's who he be. He's your enemy.
Right.
God said that. When we got off auction blocks, we were sold to who? Our enemies. The same one that's bringing drugs into our community today for you to go back and sell them to the homeboy. For you to go back and sell them to my auntie. For you to go back and sell them to my cousin. That's what the white man did. Does that sound like love to you? Does that sound like love to you, my sister? So who did we learn to hate from? The white man.
Right.
Read it again.
Envy thou not the oppressor.
We got to stop envying our oppressor. We got to learn how to love how God said to love. Come on.
And choose none of his ways.
What the Bible say?
And choose none of his ways.
God says, don't choose any of the ways of our oppressors. Give me John chapter 13, verse 34, I think. All right? These are the ways we're supposed to know. We're supposed to, the love that we should have, the love that we should have today, should make all nations thirsty to have what we have. Is that what I want?
The book of John, chapter 13, and verse 34. A new commandment I give unto you, that ye love one another.
What's the Bible say?
That ye love one another.
This is our history right here. We're not supposed to be envying our oppressor. Say it again. You say, but we do. Yeah, I know. Right? But guess what, sister? Do you wear pants? Do you wear pants? Yes, do you wear pants? Yes, you know that's a way of the oppressor? Yes, we learned that from the white man and the white woman. The whole feminist movement is when our sisters started wearing pants. We envied our oppressors. That's why our sisters walk around in pants today. Yes, dresses is what all our sisters supposed to be clothed in. Modest dresses, not ones that show your whole legs. You understand? Our sisters should be ashamed of that, right? But not no more. That's not how sisters are today. Our sisters wear whatever the hell they want to wear. And who gonna tell them not to? Say it again? Yeah, but I'm talking about America here because all the other countries learned to be how America is today. The same way we envy our oppressors, we become like the white man. That's the way Europe, that's the way Africa, that's the way South America, that's the way Canada has envied America and become like America. It's the same thing. All right? God say don't do that. This is the love we supposed to have. Read it again from the top.
A new commandment I gave unto you, that ye love one another.
That we what?
That ye love one another as I have loved you, that ye also love one another. By this shall all men know that ye are my disciples if ye have love one to another.
That's the love we supposed to have for each other out here. Now, is that the ghetto today? Is that the ghetto today? So that's why we come here. We got to come here to teach the love of God to our people. 1 John chapter 5, verse 3. You see all these police out here patrolling our neighborhoods? We supposed to be doing that. The black man supposed to be to have the authority in his neighborhood. But you know why the black man ain't got no authority? Because the black woman always called the damn police on him when she get mad. That's what happened. The black woman get mad, she called the damn police. That's what happened. And then the police come in and take the black man to jail. That's what happened. So when the police come, you know what the black man do? He runs. He scatters. He runs. You understand? Yeah, black men are killing each other. They are. I understand that. They learned that from their oppressor. They learned that from their oppressor. All right, before you start looking for a good black man, you got to become a good black woman.
Right.
Read what you got.
The book of 1 John, chapter 5 and verse 3.
What?
For this is the love of God, that we keep his commandments.
We can't truly say we love God or we love ourselves if we're not keeping God's commandments.
Nation is men leading by example.